Good morning, very good morning children. Please, how are you all? Hope you are all fine. Yes, yes. Then we will start, children. We will start. Yes, no need to waste the time, right? Yes, let us start. Then, what is the thought for the day today? Today, the thought for the day, you were born with wings, don't crawl. Learn to use them to fly and fly. Yes, you think whether you are born with the wings. Then, no need to crawl, no? You should not crawl. You should learn how to fly. You should use your wings how to fly high and high. Okay? Yes. That is the thought for the day for today. Yes, children? Yes, then we will start. Yes, please take out your workbook part 1. Yes. Yes. So, we completed till page number? Yes. 38. Right, children? Yes. What we learned in previous class? Yes, singular, plural, then countable, uncountable nouns, right children? Yes, this and all we learned in the previous class. Yes, do you remember what are singular, plurals and all? Yes, singular means one, plural means more than one or many, right children? If the word which is ending with O, X, yes, right, you will use ES to make it as plural, right? Then we learned that even Y also. Yes, if we have Y, then letters ending with Y, then what we will add? We will add IES to that. What we will add? IES to that. Right? Then X, CH, SH, SS. Right? For that and all, we will use ES. Right? Example like tax, taxes. Yes, buffalo, buffaloes. Bus, buses. Yes, church, churches, bush, bushes, kiss, kisses, like that. Right, children? Yes, then, F. If it is ending with F or F-E, we will remove F and F-E. And what we will use? We will use V-E. And we will use S also for that, right? Then, V-E-S we will add, right? Example, knife, knives. Then, thieves, thieves. Right? Then, roof, roofs. Yes, chief, chiefs. See, roof, chief and all, it is same. Yes, no need to add IES like that, VES. We will use ES. We can add yes to that. Right? Yes, this is all we learned in previous class, right children? Then we learn countable and uncountable nouns. What is countable nouns? The things which we can count, not only things, animal, person, anything let it be, which is able to count is called a countable noun. The uncountable noun is which we cannot count at all. Right? Example, rice. Yes, then milk. Then wheat flour. Yes, this and all we cannot count. Right? This and all are uncountable nouns. Are you getting children? Yes, this and all we learned in previous class. Right? Yes. We are using a, and one before the singular for the countable nouns. Right? For uncountable nouns, what we will use? What we cannot use? We cannot use a and numbers before uncountable nouns. For that, we will not use this and all. Right? This and all we learned in the previous class, right? Yes. Then we completed exercise 3.3, 3.4, right? Now, formal writing, page number 39. Open page number 39. Here we have friendly letter. Think about how you communicate with the different types of people. How you communicate with different types of people, children? You see a certain tone when you communicate with your friends. Certain tone you will be having, right, to communicate with your friends. Do you use the same tone, words and phrases to communicate with your parents or teachers? Can you communicate? Yes, you will not be able to communicate. Yes, with your parents you will communicate with English. No, with your mother tongue only, right? But with the teachers, you will use English, right? So, there is a difference in communication also. Read extracts from two letters to understand the difference between friendly and formal letters. Like that only in letters also we have friendly letters and formal letters. Okay? See here, dear Mridula. Okay? Dear Mridula, how are you? We all are fine. This Diwali, everybody in the colony is putting up a big show. I know that you will enjoy it. Why don't you come over for the Diwali? lots of love, Rahul. Yes, like that you can write a letter. Yes, you are a grade 5 kids. You can write the letters in this format also. Okay. Then this is a friendly letter which is written like this, right? You are inviting your friend for the Diwali. Yes, that will be a friendly letter. But here formal letter, how it will be? See, dear sir, I read in the local newspaper that you have set up a new kids club. I am very interested to join it. I would be grateful if you could share more information. Kindly include details about the location, timing, cost and eligibility as well. Looking forward to your response. Yours sincerely, Mehak Chauhan. Chauhan, okay, it's like this. This will make a formal letter that you are requesting for others. Like if you write a leave letter for your teacher, your class teacher, right? Then it becomes a what? Formal writing, right? Then if you want a leave, you need to ask the permission to your principal ma'am. Okay, for that you should write, dear respected principal ma'am, as I am not feeling well from 1 week, so this problem I have, so I will not be able to continue these days. I will not be able to come and attend the classes. Like that you can write your own sentence and make it. That will become a formal letter. But when you are writing to your friend or your parents or your neighbors and all, it becomes a friendly letter there. Okay? Yes, hope you are understanding. Yes, children? Yes. What are the difference between two letters written by Rahul and Mehak? Good. Get into groups of 4 and discuss the difference. Refer the following pointers. Yes. Who is it addressed to? Yes. See, here they have forgotten in the letter address. Yes, children. See, both did not write the address. Yes. But greeting. Yes, greeting. Greeting or that is dear. Yes, dear sir. Like the greeting they have used. Style of the letter. Style of the letter. See how the style of the letter also is different. What is the message? Is the main message they have been written. How does the letter end? How it is ending? Very good, it is ending. Right? Correctly it is ending. But the address only they have not mentioned. Right? Yes. Then turn next page. We write letters for different purposes. Different purposes we are writing the letters. We write letters to our friends or to request our teacher to give permission for leave when we are sick. I already told you, when we are sick, we will ask the permission from the teacher, right? Teacher or principal, right? So that becomes a formal letter. When we send different based on whom we are addressing to them. Yes, for whom we are addressing also it makes difference there, right? Formal writings are written to an adult, a person of authority or somebody that we are not close to. Yes, we are not close to if you are sending. Yes, so that makes a formal letter there. Friendly letters are written to friends, families or somebody we are familiar with, we are very close with them. So for that person we can write it in a friendly letter way. Okay, let us look at some difference between the two forms of letters. Two forms of letters are there. Let us read that. Okay, children? Yes. See, in page number 40. Yes, we have some of the formal letter here. Yes, polite and impersonal tone. Yes, polite and impersonal tone we can use. Constructions, slang and abbreviations avoided. That done, you should avoid. Then as a specific format, you should use a specific format. Start with dear, Mr. or Mrs. or Miss, Mr. or Mrs. or Miss. Okay. Or dear sir or madam. Like that you can use in this way. Okay. When you are writing the letter. Okay. Then this is a formal letter. Formal letter, this and all you should use. Okay. The next way what we have, to be the point or official. It should be in a official way when you are writing.
Hence with request, you have to request, because you are writing a leave letter means you need to request. So that should be there. Written with specific goal, specifically which is your main intention, that should be mentioned in that letter. Ends with regards or yours sincerely or faithfully. Yes, these only we should use in the formal letters when you are ending. Regards or yours sincerely or faithfully, yours faithfully, like that you should end. Okay, then in friendly letter, personal and casual tone. Personal and casual tone should be. Can use constructions and abbreviations. Okay, yes, abbreviations also you can use. Then construction also you can use. No specific format, nothing specifically you should mention. Okay, start with hello, hi, dear, like that you can start the letter. Okay, then informal and friendly in words choice. Informal and friendly it should be in your choice. Okay, hence by requesting a meeting or a reply soon. Okay, you should ask when we will meet, like that, or when we will you should reply soon, I am waiting for your reply, like that. Okay, you should mention. Then no specific agenda needed. No specific agenda, specifically nothing need to tell. Okay, then at last you should end with love or best wishes, keep in touch, like that you can end the letter. Are you getting, children? Let us practice writing a friendly letter in this module. You can practice in this module how you can write the letter. You can practice. Okay, yes, then next, see here, read the given sample of a friendly letter carefully. Name the different parts of the letter and study its format. Okay, study its format. This is the format. Okay, see, is there a need to include the address of the person you are writing to? It is important. You should write the address of the person whom you are going to write. Very important. Yes, when you are writing letter, that should go in the post. Then your address, that person's address is very important, right? So yes, tick yes. Okay, then next what we have here, this is the address. Yes, the address is very important. This is the sender's address. Whom you are sending, right? Your address should be. Okay, B12 or 3, Purbasha Estate, Shillong. Okay. This is, write down here, sender's address. You are only sending, right? Then your address only. So you would write here, sender's address. Okay. Then next, 23 July 2019. This is a date. You have to mention here, write here, date. Then next, dear Ruman. Dear Ruman is greeting. You are greeting them, right? Greeting or salutation. Write down here, greetings or salutation. Okay, this slash is only or this option. Okay, then next, how are you? Uncle told me that you are regularly participating in skating competitions now. That sounds very interesting. Yes, this is the introduction. How you should start the first paragraph. Okay, in the introduction way, how are you? I am fine. My uncle told this, mother told like that. Okay, you can mention like that. Okay, like in this way. This will become an introduction. Write down here, introduction. Yes, write down now itself, children. Next is, thank you for the great gift you sent for grandma. She is still recovering from her ankle injury and has not been able to walk properly ever since. But now, with the help of your walker, she has started to practice walking again. It really is very useful. Yes, this is the main thing, what purpose you are writing the letter. This is the main thing. This is the body. Okay, write down body. Yes, then next, visit us soon so that we can talk more. Yes, visit soon that we can talk more. Okay, closing paragraph. So you are closing the letter, you are finishing the letter in this way. Okay, last sentence you will write like that. That is closing paragraph. Write down here, closing paragraph. Then next, what we have, lots of love, Bharat. Your signature name. Okay, yes, that is the last one. You should mention lots of love, then you should mention your name as your signature. Okay. Then next what we have, exercise 4. In the morning, Rahul had to fight with his friend Shyam about who the better football player between two was. By evening, Rahul started to feel bad. He wrote a letter to his friend. Complete the letter by filling in the gaps. Yes, here one friend is fighting with other friend in football game. Okay, they have been fought. But after fighting, one friend felt very bad. So what he thought, he will write one apology letter to him. So he thought like that, and he started writing. Here they have some gaps. Okay, you need to fill it with the correct sentence. Okay, you have to fill it with correct sentence and write that and complete that letter. Okay, now let us see. Children, here first address.
So you can write the address like this. Antarava Colony. Okay, like that you should write. Then already Mumbai they have given. You can write this any date and month here also. Now if you are writing present, then you should mention the present date. Okay, I have mentioned 16th April 2019 like that. You can mention this year only, no problem. Okay. Then turn next page. Then next, dear Shyam, I am writing this letter to, yes, I will write on the board, children. You can copy.
I have already written, children. Yes, like this you should write. See, in your textbook, page number 42, see here, dear Shyam.
Okay, I am writing this letter to, okay, after that you need to complete it. Continue, okay.
Yes, write down. Apologies for the fight that we had this morning. I am really feeling bad about it. Okay, this morning they have fought. So he's asking apology means sorry. Okay. I am really feeling bad about it. He's feeling bad about it. So football game. Football is a game. Yes, it is in the book, textbook only. Then you have dash right on the children. That is fun. I am sorry about forgetting this and fighting with you during the game. Yes, forgetting that football is a game. He is forgetting that. And he started fighting with his friend. So he is telling about that. Okay. Football cannot be. Here it is in the textbook. Then dash should start writing. Played alone without a friend like you playing, football would be very boring. Without friend, without a team, can we play football, children? No, we need a team, right? Yes. So, I forgot that, but I started fighting like that recently. If both of us were equally good, both are equally good at the time, then such a game would never end. That type of good game would never end. That is why somebody has to lose other person to win. If somebody we should lose, then only the other person can win. Okay? It is as simple as that. It is as simple as that. Now he is telling, I promise you that. He is promising, I won't fight with you again. I won't fight again. I will be waiting you near the stadium. Waiting for him near the stadium tomorrow. And I am sure you will come and you will come. Our wonderful football. Yes, we have wonderful football players. I am sure that we will carry the winner's trophy. Yes, winner's trophy we will win together like that, he said. Back home in the next week. Yes, back home. I will go back home to my home next week. Okay. So let us make up and practice art. So let us make up and practice art. Yes. Like that. Okay, please write down how it's a children. Copy down this. Yes? Yes. Watch the video and please complete it. Then next we have autobiography. Yes, autobiography. We have about APJ Abdul Kalam. And we have next what we have? We have your biography. Yes, you should write biography about yours also. That also it is there. Yes. So I think today this much enough. Autobiography writing. We will continue in the next class. Okay, children. So please watch the video. video and complete this. Okay. Yes, then page only, nothing more homework, only two homeworks only, page number 41 and 42. Okay. Till here you should complete it. Okay. Already we did from page number 39, 40, 41, 42. Till that we completed, right? So in the next class we will start autobiography. Okay. Yes. Then today this is enough. We will meet in the next class. Bye.